Hi, Pageant family. I'm Danny Walker. Welcome to this episode. It's all about my favorites for Miss USA 2020. If you're new and you love content about pageants, beauty, fashion, business, and inspiration, then please subscribe to my channel and also hit the notifications bell. If you do that, you'll know when new episodes come out every week on Wednesdays, but you'll also know when my bonus episodes are released as well. I really appreciate you clicking this episode, and I love listening to all of your requests for new episodes. So don't be shy. If you have a request for a new episode, you can leave it in the comments, or you can always DM me on Instagram, and while you're there, don't forget to follow me as well. As Luciere always says, the cream will rise, and I see it rising. So let's start by talking about Miss Georgia USA, who was also Miss Georgia America. She was one of my favorites at Miss America her year, oh my goodness. And she has been so active, well, as active as you can be, I would say, during this time. She has been volunteering and serving frontline workers. She served as a pageant judge, which I think is really beneficial. It helps you to understand things from a judge's perspective. And she's also been releasing some really fabulous pageant images. It's just putting her out there like, hey, I'm in this to win this. So I have loved that about her. Now, since she is from the Miss America organization and the training for that is very different from the training for Miss USA, I think that what she needs to focus on is going to be making sure that she is very relaxed and very personable for the onstage questions that they ask you that aren't even really judged for the preliminary and semifinalist announcements, as well as for an onstage question if she were to make it to a top five. So those are my thoughts. She's gotta keep it real cool and relaxed and be very Miss USA and not Miss America. And if you were having those same thoughts, then comment same down below. Next is Louisiana. You have heard lots about her if you watch any of my other episodes, and if you want to hear more about her, then check this episode out right here. She did several appearances pre-COVID, and I think that if we hadn't have experienced a global pandemic, then she would have been really active. But since then, she's been posting regularly online. She also created a virtual girls conference, and I thought that that was a really great idea, so she's still able to reach out to young women. She's also staying really fit. I'm just like, whoa, oh my gosh, I can't even imagine how much time she's had to work out in the gym in these past couple months, but she's looking fantastic. Absolutely love her, and I really see her putting in an effort. Miss Texas USA, love her. I probably see the most from her, and that sort of makes sense. I feel like Texas title holders always have the most beautiful images. Speaking of, shout out to my sister Queen Logan. She just got engaged, and all I ever see from her online are these beautiful, beautiful photos, and she's continued that well beyond her reign. And I love her so much, and I think that that's something that Texas queens have done really, really well, is stay active online. Now, because there aren't as many appearance opportunities, we haven't seen Taylor out in her community, which makes a lot of sense. We've seen more photos from photo shoots or kind of behind the scenes, and I love seeing that too. But she did mention that she is a survivor of domestic abuse earlier in her reign, and I have a feeling that that is really what she's gonna zero in on at Miss USA. So that's what I expect to hear from her, and more about that story and her work with domestic violence or domestic abuse victims. In the past few years, Nevada has done a really great job prepping their queens, and that's why they've continued to place or be in that top five, and I think this year is no different. Victoria is one of my friends, so I can attest to the fact that she is such a kind and loving individual, and I love her for that. What she wants to focus on this year is something she has a personal connection with, and that is ending gun violence without infringing upon Second Amendment rights. So she's been really outspoken about that, and that's what I would assume that she is going to be talking about a lot during the pageant, or if she were to become Miss USA. But as I said, Nevada's done such a great job preparing their queens, but I think that the reason that we haven't had a Nevada since 2014 win Miss USA is just because they need a little bit more work for onstage question, which is really a challenge for anyone, but I think that they have such awesome representatives at Miss USA. Remember, if you love these episodes, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notifications bell so you know when new episodes come out. And also follow me on social media at Danny Walker. It would be a huge deal if you would just take a screenshot of this episode, share your thoughts, post it to an Instagram story, tag me and hashtag me at Danny Walker so I can hear from you and know what you thought about this episode. Miss Idaho USA, another huge favorite of mine. Kim is so down to earth, and that's really what I love about her. She's been really outspoken throughout the past several months about health, especially during COVID. And I think that makes a lot of sense. She works in health and sciences. She wants to be a veterinarian. And I think that public health would be the issue that she can speak from experience about, or at least from a position where she has a little bit more knowledge or has done some more research on it. So I think that's really what she'd be focusing on. My only concern for her would be wardrobe and styling going forward. Idaho in the past several years has not had the most fashion forward styling that we've seen at Miss USA, or like really captures that Miss USA vibe or look. So that would be my only concern for Kim at Miss USA. Miss Oklahoma, she's been another one of my favorites, and I just love her more and more. I've been looking at her online, and I feel like she's one of those contestants who's doing her best to be really creative with what she can post. She even posted a travel vision board, which I was a huge fan of, and she's just using that as a way to share more and connect with her audience online. And right now, when you can't make a lot of appearances, I think that that's just as important as going on appearances, just being able to engage with people, to start different conversations. So I think that that is really wonderful, and I've noticed her doing that. She has an emphasis, and she wants to share more about mental health, and she has been really active posting about those issues. So I would expect her to share a lot more about that Miss USA, and I think it would be a really great platform for her to share more about. Last but certainly not least is Miss New York USA, and I can really see her going home with the crown this year. She is an immigrant. She speaks 4 different languages, and she has been so outspoken about racial injustice throughout this year. She has spoken publicly about this. Her posts are centered around this, and I think that right now during these times, it would just make a lot of sense for her to win. I think that she is really poised for the job, and that she has been so active regardless of what's been going on in her community. As I said, she's been doing some public speaking. She has talked a lot online, but she's also continued to volunteer and help others. And I can really see her putting in the work. I really kind of see her sailing right on through to that top 5, and would not be surprised if New York is our winner this year for Miss USA, but time will tell. We will see. I really want to wish all the contestants this year good luck. I know that social media doesn't share everything, but I can't think of a Miss USA in recent years that has not been active on social media leading up to her winning. I can't think of a Miss USA that has had an Instagram feed with maybe 5 photos on it, or an Instagram or social media that's just filled with photos of selfies. And if I'm wrong, then please comment down below. Tell me who had social media like that prior to winning Miss USA. But really, I think that there is a strong correlation between the things that these young women are sharing on social media and the work that they're actually doing in their communities, and the work that they're putting in to prepare for the title of Miss USA. So these are my thoughts about this year's batch of contestants. These are the contestants that I really see edging closer and closer to the crown. But what are your thoughts? Who are your favorites for this year's pageant? And what do you think about the pageant being held at Graceland? Someone told me online that they're only allowing 75 audience members, not including the VIP section, but I don't know if that's true. I think that it would be a really cool venue. I wish that I could go. I doubt that I can if they're only allowing 75 people into the audience. I'm pretty sure the show is already sold out. But tell me what you think about this year's competition, and if you think that they should have even had a competition this year, or should it have been a virtual Miss USA? I don't know. What are your thoughts on it? I would love to hear that. And don't forget that if you're prepping for your next pageant, click the description and take advantage of my free pageant prep crash course. It's going to give you lots of extra tips and teach you how to prepare to take home the title. So I hope that that helps you. I wish you the best luck if you are competing at a pageant. And then I hope you come back every single week for lots of new tips. Thanks for watching this episode.